See what happens when sin enters the world? Subjectivity comes in, objective truth goes out. That's what happens in the present. That's why to overcome sin, you need humility. You need to be able to say, I did this. I am guilty. Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned. This is the beginning of salvation. But Adam and Eve didn't do that. They blamed, they finger-pointed, and they went on about their own business. God comes into time and space because time and space is what's been torn and ripped apart. Our human natures, our body and soul, have been ripped apart from each other. One of the, what's called preternatural, before the state of nature, gifts that we enjoyed was immortality. We didn't die. We didn't die. The body and soul were made to be together with each other. We are ensouled flesh. That's what we are. You take the soul away, the flesh turns to dust. That's what we are. They're meant to be together. The body gives the soul expression in time and space. You laugh, you cry, you hug somebody you love. That moment when he was conceived in the womb of Our Lady is the fulfillment of the promise of crushing the head of Satan. Every gear is in place now, the wheels are rolling, and there is no stopping him. So because you are lukewarm and neither hot nor cold, I will vomit you out of my mouth. Who is he saying this to? He's saying this to Christian believers. He is not saying this to the Jewish Pharisees and scribes and leadership. He's not saying this to the pagans or the Greeks or the rest of the Gentiles. He is saying this to people who have professed a belief in him and their belief has grown lukewarm. And whatever Christ asks us to do, we've got to do. Whatever happens in the future, we must stand up and be Christ to the world. And when Christ stood up, he was crucified. Whatever the cost, we must pay it with a total assurance and full hope that he will raise us as he raised his son. That's love. And love is the secret to salvation.